distribution funds. The fact that there is.
I want the credit to be about $69,000.
Yeah.
Just off the top of my head, when I said 69, you get your 3 and 23s.
Oh, I know, because once you start messing with numbers, everything is numbers. I did that for a long time.
Seems like 46 weeks after the Pope's birthday. So, yeah. Trump has a lot of
thoughts around catechism.
Kind of, sort of. There's a lot of, like, Catholicism and whatnot, yeah. Basically, what really the Catholic Church is, like, the Vatican and whatnot, are basically what you call, like, fake Christians. Like, they would. Without going too deep into it, obviously they don't have people best at hand when they conscript stories like somebody died, you know, whatever.
Or mass hysteria.
Yeah. Basically, they're like a secret group in a sense where they're really high up there. Another group would be the Federal Reserve, Rothschild family. They're like 1A, 1B right there. If they work together, a lot of things like that. I know a lot of the numerology off of the Catholic Church, and that kind of affects us more, obviously, here, and then more of the Middle East, Israel connection, all that, more Europe. But I mean, Federal Reserve prints all the money, they find out the corporations, they tell everybody what to do, so then everybody comes
with the CIA.
Oh, yeah, yeah, all the same. I have a book. I have books that I'm sure I got high. I'm going up on the watch list. Like, it talks about how the watch list is a drug dealer, or a driver, and all the
bombs,
but yeah,
I've only been listening to, like, okay, so I did rabbit hole shit when I was like in my early 20s, freaking stuff the fuck out. It's like, nah, I gotta get off that before I'm just a crazed person all the time, and that's not how I wanna, like, you know, make this, like, my mentality,
hey,
just the person I am, how I was raised, and things like that. Plus, you go into doing all that and finding that out.
That's right.
I'm feeling manipulated,
and,
like,
I'm purposely trying to.
I don't know.
That plane wreck, they found the plane and all that, and then released a body picture.
Not only that, but Ontario
did the picture survive the plane crash? There's different things. So then,
on top of that,
the news, they go, oh, is Israel involved with the killing? Right, so the last like 10-ish years, like really,
it's probably gonna be as bad as that one.
You have like Trump with a character in politics.
We didn't expect that.
Just China, Mexico, that kind of stuff. So, really, since then, it's sort of all like that, where China supposedly is the big point of power now. You've got the Russia connection, you've got the specifically. But you know what I'm saying, I can tell, where you have more of the American side, they're more involved with Israel and stuff like that. Now, Israel. Actually, I'll know a lot more about that. So you got a setup where they can do like the next world war would be America, Israel, a place like Ukraine. You have like Russia, China, Iran. Both their teams won a championship the same year in 2022 because of their color scheme. It's the same colors as the Ukraine flag, right when Ukraine was the war. Yep. That's why they legalized it, because everyone's like, okay, I definitely think this team will win. And the other team has, so like, how'd that happen?
Right.
You know, there's players that came out and they're like, well, we got scripts and all this stuff. I would have to have an injury to beat me. I'd be up 4 weeks.
Yeah.
Also, ironically, man, I want to get this 100% right. I'll say the second part. So, it was on the 22nd anniversary when America went to war in Afghanistan. So it would have been 2023. So it's post 9/11. So it's like 1 or 2. 22 years later is when, I want to say that's when the Middle East, like Iran, whatever country it is, attacked Israel. I believe it's the exact. So.
Yeah.
There's a lot with Israel and Bible now, depending on different things, how well you know the Bible. Someone talks about the fake ones that we run in Israel and whatnot, which would be the Federal Reserve ones. You go back to history about how I'm trying to get this PG-13 as possible. The people were kicked out for many things, and then in the 40s, Israel, that land was now owned by the Rothschilds, the Federal Reserve. That was given to them in a treaty post World War II to go into the money control, that type of stuff. So the state of Israel is different from Israel prior. That came up with Israel, because Israel is kind of sort of like the children of God and stuff like that. So when they named them, does all these crazy things, then the Christian would support them, thinking that's what they meant in life. So, you know, Israel came up for many times saying, like, we'll hope we have to hurt teams never run against us. They test a lot of things out over there, too, a lot of rules. Obviously, I want you to understand about like the Federal Reserve, Rothschilds. Basically, what they're doing, as crazy as it sounds, it's almost kind of similar to a Holocaust, what it was called, where you're just attacking your own people. And really, they're doing that in every country, but they do it through money manipulation, even things they're not like getting necessarily, like raising prices, not letting things come into the country. And there's so many different things, and like, you know, this is like, to understand all this, you have to be kind of evil. So I'm probably a daily researcher for about 5-6 years. So this was not one of the first things I learned. I learned more about the symbols and the patterns of the countries in different countries, how they're called, how this and that, and other countries jump in. They created the KKK, if you all know that. There's also black society too, so you know, like specifically black people that would be offended by the stereotypes that not like the actual main people. Basically everyone below them will never get that. But I can tell you something else in a book that they read specifically says that World War III starts when Middle East, the political Zionists, which we observe all throughout Israel, goes to war with the Middle East. So, Hamas, whatever, Middle East attacks Israel. Like I was saying, how you kind of have America jumps in, Russia jumps in, China jumps in, but you got right after that, for about 10 years, the Patriots win. That's a long time. Patriots. The only team they really ever lose to are the New York Giants when 9/11 happened.
And that was the only game that they really had.
Yeah, those are the main. They lost twice to the Giants.
Yeah.
And the Giants were like 9-7 that year. Like they were mediocre at
right.
best. And they go, okay, they're in the Super Bowl. They're going to lose, right?
No, they're not.
And the most ridiculous script, basically, both of them were like crazy catches. The one guy catches the ball on his helmet. Like, he catches the ball, puts on his helmet before he goes down. The other guy, he's on the sideline with one hand. Like, come on. There's a whole thing that sports people don't like to hear. But like, pay attention, a lot of them wear gloves and stuff, and they have stickiness. Also have technology in the balls where they can stick it in the air and they go, all right, slow the ball down to me, and the guy's still behind, but you can catch it, get the ball into the goalpost, make an answer go in. That was one of the things I really couldn't get people to understand about sports. I was like,
how casting that really
is. Yeah. Who goes to what team? All of those stuff.
They don't draft out, like, people
yeah.
have a choice.
Yeah.
And that's just like the election.
You have a vote. Uh-huh. You're a Democrat or Republican.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Like,
it shouldn't be either. You would
yeah.
think. But...
Right. Yeah.
And then especially the way it is now, I would think that would turn people off just because of how divisive people are. Where, why would you want to pick a side when the TV just tells you this person's bad, this person's good, this
right.
is bad, this is good.
And that's where I'm like, you don't even know these people for real.
Right.
They can tell you anything that they want to.
They look through their
Why
history.
Do you think? Like,
so,
they're literally just there to be people in the positions.
Right.
They're following whatever order is from whoever.
Right. So I can get Trump connection, 47th president, a couple things. So there's a president, Grover Cleveland. He was one of the 50 presidents who was president. Away he passed a trick plan. So yeah, that connection. Then after the Cavaliers in 2016, Trump visits Kendall Clark. So now he's 47 president. There's a whole thing there too. You've got until December until he's actually president. There's a lot of rumors of that for that for many years. One of his main quotes that he said was, he said, I've done more than 47 books. Biden has done 47 books. Of 47. I thought for sure, like the last two, I thought were kind of 50-50. I thought, at first, I thought they'd go with Kamala Harris, and then the way they started talking, and then they had the shooting and so forth, I was like, Trump was. I could have
been on it. I don't care anyway, but I'm just
right.
watching
his character is based on
yeah.
confidence.
Right.
book right there?
Yeah. There's a lot behind that. So, my now, he's perfect. He's perfect mental health.
I
said from the beginning.
Did you see when they met?
He's
on drunk. He's talking to other
they fucking drugged him and put him away. Yeah, they can easily do that. I know, so Biden, Kamala Harris, and Trump went to 9/11 memorial this year. So, pre-election, they're all standing there, buddy, buddy. But they can't stand each other on the news. There's so, like, it eventually comes to me. Each of them were based on a character on TV shows. I forget the movie that Trump's based on. It's not carbon copy, but people that would hate Trump, they would look at it like screams, yells, talks about all the countries were happening. Biden's character is based on, I believe it's Scary Movie and Pop Shots. Incompetent president, he's saying things like he doesn't know who his wife is, from his sister, this and that. He talks about how he's like, they're gonna say you're incompetent. And Trump says, oh, I can prove that just as easily as they can. Just like when they did the thing with Biden, where he didn't fit to tell his wife and his sister or whatever, how he's on stage and speaking to a crowd or whatever, and he turns around and stuff like that, falls up the steps, can't ride a bike, just different things. I'm like, this is the fakest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, because then, like you said, perfect time. And it didn't miss a beat, he was speaking to everybody.
Yep.
I was like,
yeah, they're both. Think about it, Trump and Biden are both over 75. Like, people don't think that.
Right.
So, I think
they're
about
old.
Yeah, I think about our, my grandparents.
Yeah.
Because one would lean more towards one lifestyle, one would lean more towards the other side.
Yeah.
And I think it's like them arguing.
Yeah.
And I always feel like I have more. I mean, I do, eventually, but, you know. And then, Kamala Harris is based on a character from a show called V-E-E-P. There's, her name is Julia Louis-Dreyfus. And she basically kind of talks like Kamala doing the speeches and say things like, she has a speech about something about going to work, getting the work done, going home. I don't know. Just speaking in circles, not
right.
Really making
words.
Word
salad.
Yeah. And it's like, if you compare them next to each other, it's spot on. You couldn't get a better script.
So they're all doing a really good job.
Oh, yeah. There's a lot behind the name Kamala. There's a wrestler, Kamala, who died. There's. Her dad's name is Donald J. Harris, like Donald J. Trump. Yeah. How. Go into different things with Bill Clinton, San Francisco, where she was a politician or whatever. Based on numerology and stuff, I haven't really looked at it that much, honestly. I know more of like what's being shown in front of me. I'm like, okay, that's all. And I can say, connect this to that. But it's a daily thing. I mean, we're all looking at all. And it's like, you don't remember all the other stuff, but when it's put together, I think I watched a video in like 2017 or something like that. I watched a few videos and I started to see like they were talking about how like you can't really achieve fame and stuff like that, how you have to know people and all that. And I just kind of got my balls. So, a couple years, I was listening to music a couple years. Like, it was really just repetition, and I started like daily, and I was like, oh, it's more like to get people to understand it first. Right. Then you start going about words and for this and that.
This is one set of
Like I know a lot of sports stuff and I can say, well, why this happened, why that happened. 5 Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And you were probably 5, right?
Okay.
I just thought we were still 1 or something. But yeah.
I
Thank you.